Welcome to Alliance Military Database. Classified information requested. Establishing secure connection. Secure connection confirmed. Please log in to access your profile. Warning, data corruption detected. Please reconstruct profile. Confirm pre-service history. Confirm psychological profile. Confirm military specialization. Confirm facial identification. Profile reconstruction complete. Identification confirmed.
Well, what about Shepard? He's a spacer, lived aboard starships most of his life.
Military service runs in the family. Both his parents were in the Navy.
He proved himself during the Blitz. Held off enemy forces on the ground until reinforcements arrived.
He's the only reason Elysium is still standing.
We can't question his courage.
Humanity needs a hero. And Shepard's the best we've got.
I'll make the call.
Thrusters, check. Navigation, check. Internal emission sync engaged. All systems online. Drift, just under 1500K.
1500 is good. Your captain will be pleased.
I hate that guy.
Nihlus gave you a compliment. So you hate him.
You remember to zip up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead. So that's incredible. Besides, Spectres are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid. The Council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. But only an idiot believes the official story.
You always expect the worst.
Well, bad feelings are an occupational hazard. But we don't go anywhere unless there's a good reason, so... what are we doing here?
Joker! Status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance Brass before we reach Eden Prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihlus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant. Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
You get that, Commander?
Great. You pissed the Captain off, and now I'm going to pay for it.
Don't blame me. The Captain's always in a bad mood.
Only when he's talking to you, Joker.
The Systems Alliance is an independent supranational government representing the interests of humanity as a whole. The Alliance is responsible for the governance and defense of all extrasolar colonies and stations. The Alliance grew out of the various national space programs as a matter of practicality. Sol's planets had been explored and exploited through piecemeal national efforts. The expense of colonizing entire new solar systems could not be met by any one country. With humans knowing that alien contact was inevitable, there was enough political will to jointly fund an international effort. Still, the Alliance was often disregarded by those on Earth until the First Contact War. While the national governments dithered and bickered over who should lead the effort to liberate Shanxi, the Alliance fleet struck decisively. Post-war public approval gave the Alliance the credibility to establish its own parliament and become the galactic face of humanity. Roughly 1,200 years ago, the Turians were invited to join the Citadel Council to fulfill the role of galactic peacekeepers. The Turians have the largest fleet in Citadel space, and they make up the single largest portion of the Council's military forces. As their territory and influence has spread, the Turians have come to rely on the Salarians for military intelligence and the Asari for diplomacy. Despite a somewhat colonial attitude towards the rest of the galaxy, the ruling hierarchy understands they would lose more than they would gain if the other two races were ever removed. Turians come from an autocratic society that values discipline and possesses a strong sense of personal and collective honor. There is lingering animosity between Turians and humans over the First Contact War of 2157, which is known as the Relay 314 incident to the Turians. Officially, however, the two species are allies, and they enjoy civil, if cool, diplomatic relations.
We're getting dragged, right along with him.
Relax, Presley. You're gonna give yourself an ulcer.
Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down to see the Captain?
Sounds like you don't trust our Turian guest.
Sorry, Commander. Just having a chat with Adams down in Engineering. It didn't mean to cause any trouble. But you have to admit, something's odd about this mission. The whole crew feels it.
You think the Alliance Brass is holding out on us?
If all we're supposed to do is test out the stealth system, why is Captain Anderson in charge? And then there's Nihlus. Spectres are elite operatives, top covert agents. Why send a Spectre, a Turian Spectre, on a shakedown run? It doesn't add up.
What do you know about the stealth systems?
I just know it masks our location from scans and sensors. Cutting-edge technology. The Normandy's the only ship with this prototype drive. But why are we fully staffed? A skeleton crew would be cheaper. Less chance of security leaks, too. Plus, there's Nihilus. It's pretty obvious this shakedown run is just a cover.
For what?
Damned if I know, Commander. We're out here on false pretenses. I'm not a fan of being left in the dark.
Do you have a problem with the captain?
No, sir. But I can't figure out what he's doing here. Captain Anderson is one of the most decorated Special Forces officers in the service. If he melted down all his medals, he could make a life-size statue of himself. You don't send a soldier like that on a do-nothing mission. He's treating this shakedown run too seriously. Something big is going on.
You don't trust Nihilus?
I don't like Turians in general. It runs in my family. My grandfather fought in the First Contact War. Lost a lot of friends when the Turians hit us.
That was 30 years ago. You can't blame Nihilus for that.
No, I guess not. But it still makes me nervous to have a Spectre on board. Especially a Turian. We're an Alliance vessel, human military, but Nihilus doesn't answer to the captain like the rest of us. Spectres operate outside the normal chain of command. And they don't come along just to observe shakedown runs. Nihilus looks like he's expecting some heavy action. I don't like it.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good luck, Commander.
I grew up on Eden Prime, Doc. It's not the kind of place Spectres visit. There's something Nihilus isn't telling us about this mission.
That's crazy. The captain's in charge here. He wouldn't take orders from a Spectre.
Not his choice, Doc. Spectres don't answer to anyone. They can do whatever they want. Kill anyone who gets in their way.
Oh, you watch too many spy vids, Jenkins.
What do you think, Commander? We won't be staying on Eden Prime too long, will we? I'm itching for some real action.
I sincerely hope you're kidding, Corporal. Your real action usually ends with me patching up crew members in the infirmary.
You need to calm down, Corporal. A good soldier stays cool, even under fire.
Sorry, Commander, but this waiting's killing me. I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
Just treat this like every other assignment you've had and everything will work out.
Easy for you to say. You proved yourself in the Blitz. Everybody knows what you can do. This is my big chance. I need to show the brass what I can do.
You're young, Corporal. You have a long career ahead of you. Don't do something stupid to mess it up.
Don't worry, sir. I'm not going to screw this up.
What can you tell me about Nihilus?
Turians are generally well-respected by the other species. Their fleet has more patrols protecting Citadel space than any other. They don't always get on well with us, though. Some people find them too rigid. Others still blame them for the First Contact War. As for Nihilus, I haven't said more than two words to him. He usually only speaks to the captain.
I hope we get a chance to see him in action. I heard Nihilus took down an entire enemy platoon all by himself.
What do you know about the Spectres?
Only what I've heard. Spectre agents work directly for the Citadel Council. They usually work alone or in small groups. Spectres don't have any official power, though. Basically, they're a shadow organization with a mandate to preserve and protect galactic stability.
Protect it at any cost. Don't forget that part. Spectres operate above the law.
Why don't we have any of our own people in there?
Spectres usually come from the Council races, like the Turians. We've been trying to get a human accepted into their ranks for years now. So far, it hasn't happened.
Hey, Commander, you'd make a good Spectre. You're a war hero, right? Held off an entire enemy fleet during the Blitz single-handed? That's the kind of talent the Spectres are looking for.
This is all just wild speculation. The Spectres aren't interested in recruiting humans, no matter how capable.
How do you control agents with unlimited power?
I suppose the Council could revoke the Spectre status of an agent who got out of hand. At that point, Citadel Security Services would take over.
Those C-Sec grunts wouldn't stand a chance. The Spectres were 20 ordinary soldiers. The Spectres police themselves. An agent goes rogue, they send another agent to take him down. That's Spectre justice.
The Corporal's confusing romantic legends with reality, Commander.
You're from Eden Prime, aren't you, Jenkins? What's it like?
It's very peaceful, Commander. They've been real careful with development, so you don't have any city noise or pollution. My parents lived on the outskirts of the colony. At night, I used to climb this big hill and stare across the fields back at the lights from the main settlement. It was gorgeous. But When I got older, I realized it was a little too calm and quiet for me. That's why I joined the Alliance. Even Paradise gets boring after a while.
Any idea why Eden Prime was chosen as our destination?
Not really sure, Commander. Eden Prime's one of our most stable colonies. Good place to take the Normandy for a shakedown run, I guess. No real danger there. There's gotta be something else going on. We've got a Spectre on board. That's why I'm so wound up. I can't wait for the real mission to start.
The captain's waiting for me.
Goodbye, Commander.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. It'll give us a chance to talk.
What about?
I'm interested in this world we're going to. Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
They say it's a paradise.
Yes, a paradise. Serene, tranquil, safe. Eden Prime has become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
Do you know something?
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place. Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
I figured there was something you weren't telling us.
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
There must be a reason you didn't tell me about this, sir.
This comes down from the top, Commander. Information strictly on a need-to-know basis. A research team on Eden Prime unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
This is big, Shepard. The last time humanity made a discovery like this, it jumped our technology forward 200 years. But Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this. We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
Why didn't we keep the beacon for ourselves?
You humans don't have the best reputation. Some species see you as selfish, too unpredictable, too independent, even dangerous.
Sharing that beacon will improve relations with the Council. Plus, we need their scientific expertise. They know more about the Protheans than we do.
The beacon's not the only reason I'm here, Shepard.
Nihlus wants to see you in action, Commander. He's here to evaluate you.
Guess that explains why I bump into him every time I turn around.
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
You held off an enemy assault during the Blitz single-handed. You showed not only courage, but also incredible skill. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
I assume this is good for the Alliance.
Earth needs this, Shepard. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihlus will accompany you to observe the mission.
Why is this beacon so important?
All advanced galactic civilization is based on Prothean technology, even yours.
If we hadn't discovered those Prothean ruins buried on Mars, we'd still be stuck on Earth. That was just a small data cache. Who knows what we can learn from this beacon? What if it's a weapons archive? We can't let it fall into the wrong hands.
Like who?
The Attican Traverse isn't the most stable sector of Citadel space. There are plenty of raiders and criminal groups active in the region. They might figure a Prothean beacon is worth the risk of attacking an Alliance ship. Plus, Eden Prime is right on the border of the Terminus systems.
The Attican Traverse is under Citadel protection. If the Terminus systems attack, it's an act of war.
Technically, yes. But some of the species in the Terminus might be willing to start a war over this.
The last thing the Council wants is to get dragged into a major conflict with the Terminus systems. We have to keep this low-key.
I'd like to know more about Eden Prime before we touch down.
It's a peaceful farming world, but it represents something much bigger. Eden Prime is one of our oldest and most successful colonies. It proved we were ready to face the challenges of settling new worlds, to forge a place for humanity beyond Earth. It symbolizes humanity's growth and evolution as a spacefaring species. And after this, it will be known as the world where humans made a discovery of galactic importance.
What do you know about the Protheans?
Just what they taught us in school. They were a technologically advanced species that ruled the galaxy 50,000 years ago. Then they vanished. Nobody really knows how or why, though I've heard plenty of theories. But everyone agrees, galactic civilization wouldn't exist without them.
Their citadel is the very heart of galactic society, and without their mass relays, interstellar travel would be impossible. We all owe the Protheans a great debt.
Just give the word, Captain.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got a problem.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden Prime, sir. You better see this.
Bring it up on screen.
Get down!
We are under attack, taking heavy casualties! I repeat, heavy casualties! We can't stop there! Get evac! They came out of nowhere! We need...
cuts out after that. No comm traffic at all. It just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse and hold at 38.5. Status report.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
A small strike team can move quickly without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You're going in.
Engaging stealth systems. Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
Your team's the muscle in this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihlus, you coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Nihlus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
We've got his back, Captain.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck!
We are approaching drop point two.
Ship perimeters.
Humanity's first... The Terminus systems are located on the far side of the Attican Traverse, beyond the space administered by the Citadel Council, or claimed by the Human Systems Alliance. It is populated by a loose affiliation of minor species, united only in their refusal to acknowledge the political... Spectres are agents... 50,000 years ago, the pro...
This place got hit hard, Commander. Hostiles everywhere. Your guard up.
Negative.
Damn!
That's it. Bag him and tag him.
Eden Prime will never be the same again.
We'll see that he receives a proper service once the mission is complete. But I need you to stay focused.
Aye, aye, sir.
Gunnery Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, sir?
Are you wounded, Williams?
A few scrapes and burns. Nothing serious. The others weren't so lucky. Oh, man. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit. We tried to get off a distress call, but they cut off our communications. I've been fighting for my life ever since.
Any idea what kind of enemy we're facing?
I think they're Geth.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
We could use your help, Williams.
Aye, aye, sir. It's time for payback.
What else do you know about the Geth?
Just what I remember from history class back in school. They're synthetics, non-organic life forms with limited AI programming, created by the Quarians a few centuries ago. They were supposed to be a source of cheap labor, but ended up turning on the Quarians and drove them into exile. Well, after that, they just kind of disappeared behind the Perseus Veil. Nobody's really heard much from them since.
Tell me everything you know about the Beacon.
They were doing some digging out here to extend the monorail and expand the colony. A few weeks ago, they unearthed some Prothean ruins, and the Beacon. Suddenly, every scientific expert in the colony was interested. That's when they brought us in to secure the site. I don't know much about the Beacon itself, but I heard one of the researchers say this could be the biggest scientific discovery of the century.
What happened to the researchers at the dig site?
I don't know. They set up camp near the Beacon. The 232 was with them. Maybe their unit fared better than mine.
Describe what happened leading up to the attack.
We were sent out a couple of nights ago from the main colony to secure the area. Seemed like a routine patrol, until the Geth hit us. We never knew they were coming.
Have you seen a Turian Spectre around here?
There aren't any Turians on Eden Prime. None that I've ever met. Not sure I'd be able to tell if one was a Spectre anyway.
If you saw this guy, you'd know. Carries enough firepower to wipe out a whole platoon. Luckily, he's on our side.
Sorry. Like I said, no Turians.
Move out.
Thank you.
This is the dig site. The beacon was right here. It must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
You think anyone got out of here alive?
If they were lucky. Maybe hiding up in the camp. It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
Change of plans, Shepard. There's a small spaceport up ahead. I want to check it out. I'll wait for you there.
Looks like they hit the camp hard.
It's a good place for an ambush. Keep your guard up. Oh, God. They're still alive.
What did the Geth do to them?
Hostiles!
Smells like smoke and death.
That door, it's closed. Security lock's engaged.
Humans. Thank the Maker.
Hurry. Close the door before they come back.
Don't worry. We'll protect you.
Thank you. I think we'll be okay now. It looks like everyone's gone. You're Dr. Warren, the one in charge of the excavation. Do you know what happened to the beacon?
It was moved to the spaceport this morning. Manuel and I stayed behind to help pack up the camp. When the attack came, the Marines held them off long enough for us to hide. They gave their lives to save us.
No one is saved. The age of humanity is ended. Soon, only ruin and corpses will remain.
What's wrong with your assistant?
Manuel has a brilliant mind, but he's always been a bit unstable. Genius and madness are two sides of the same coin.
Is it madness to see the future? To see the destruction rushing towards us? To understand there is no escape, no hope? No. I am not mad. I'm the only sane one left.
I gave him an extra dose of his meds after the attack.
What else can you tell me about the attack?
It all happened so fast. One second we were gathering up our equipment, The next we were hiding in the shed while the Geth swarmed over the camp.
Agents of the Destroyers, bringers of darkness, heralds of our extinction.
We could hear the battle outside. Gunfire, screams. I thought it would never end. Then everything went quiet. We just sat there, too afraid to move, until you came along.
Can you tell me anything about the beacon?
It's some type of data module from a galaxy-wide communications network. Remarkably well-preserved. It could be the greatest scientific discovery of our lifetime. Miraculous new technologies, groundbreaking medical advances. Who knows what secrets are locked inside?
We have unearthed the heart of evil. Awakened the beast. Unleashed the darkness.
Manuel, please. This isn't the time.
Did you notice a Turian in the area?
I saw him. The Prophet. Leader of the enemy. He was here before the attack.
That's impossible. Nihlus was with us in the Normandy before the attack. He couldn't have been here.
I'm sorry. Manuel's still a bit unsettled. We haven't seen your Turian. We've been hiding in here since the attack.
Williams, take us to the spaceport.
You can't stop it. Nobody can stop it. Night is falling. The darkness of eternity.
Hush, Manuel. Go lie down. You'll feel better once the medication kicks in. Yes? Is there something you need?
We better get moving.
Good luck, Commander.
Luck won't save you. You're wasting your time. The age of humanity is over. Our extinction is inevitable.
Manuel, I need to ask you something.
It's probably best if you just leave him alone.
I don't have time for this.
Time? Our time is over.
Saren. Nihlus. This isn't your mission, Saren. What are you doing here?
The Council thought you could use some help on this one.
I wasn't expecting to find the Geth here. The situation's bad.
Don't worry. I've got it under control.
Off in the distance.
It's a ship. Look at the size of it.
Everybody stay calm out there. We're coming out, we're not armed.
Is it safe? Are they gone?
You're okay now. Nobody's gonna hurt you.
Those things were crawling all around the shed. They would have found us for sure. We owe you our lives.
I still can't believe it. When we saw that ship, I thought it was all over.
It showed up right before the attack. Knew it was trouble the second I saw it, so we made a break for the sheds.
Tell me everything you remember about the attack.
The three of us were working the crops when that ship showed up.
We just saw it and ran. I don't know what happened to the rest of the crew.
They were by the garage, over near the spaceport, right where that ship came down. No way they survived.
You don't know that. We survived. If they made it to the garage, they could have had a fighting chance.
Do you know anything about the Prothean beacon they dug up?
We're just farmers. We heard they found something out there, but it never really mattered to us. Not until now.
What else can you tell me about the ship you saw?
I was too busy running to get a clear look at it. I think it landed over near the spaceport.
Tell them about the noise, Cole. That awful noise.
It was emitting some kind of signal as it descended. It sounded like the shriek of the damned. Only, it was coming from inside your own head.
It was probably trying to block communications.
Whatever it was, it felt like it was tearing right through my skull. Almost made it impossible to think.
I have to go.
Hey, Cole, we're just a bunch of farmers. These guys are soldiers. Maybe we should give them the stuff.
Jeez, Blake, you gotta learn when to shut up.
You have something to tell me, Cole?
Some guys at the spaceport were running a small smuggling ring. Nothing major. In exchange for a cut of the profits, we let them store packages in our sheds.
You're breaking the law, Cole.
We're not hurting anybody. Hell, most of the time I don't even know what's in the packages. Just thought there might be something we could use. I found a pistol. Figured it would come in handy if those things came back. But you'll probably get more use out of it than we will.
We're risking our lives to save this colony. You sure there's nothing else in here that could help us out?
Yeah, there's one more thing. I was gonna sell it after this was over, but you probably deserve it more than I do.
Who's your contact at the spaceport, Cole? What's his name?
He's not a bad guy. I don't want to get him in trouble. Besides, I'm not a snitch.
He might have something to do with this whole attack, Cole. We need his name. It's important.
Yeah, okay, you're right. His name's Powell. Works the docks at the spaceport, if he's still alive.
I have to go.
Good luck.
We thought this world was safe.
Commander, it's Nihlus.
Hey,
Hostile contact.
Something's moving over behind those crates.
Wait! Don't shoot! I'm one of you! I'm human!
Sneaking up on us like that nearly got you killed.
I am sorry. I was hiding from those creatures. My name's Powell. I saw what happened to that Turian. The other one shot him.
I need to know how Nihlus died.
The other one got here first. He was waiting when your friend showed up. He called him Saren. I think they knew each other. Your friend seemed to relax. He let his guard down. And Saren killed him. Shot him right in the back. I'm just lucky he didn't see me behind the crates.
We were told a Prothean beacon was brought to the spaceport. What happened to it?
It's over on the other platform, probably where that guy Saren was headed. He hopped on the cargo train right after he killed your friend. I knew that beacon was trouble. Everything's gone to hell since we found it. First that damn mothership showed up, then the attack. They killed everyone. Everyone! If I hadn't been behind the crates, I'd be dead too.
How come you're the only one who survived? Why didn't anyone else try to hide behind the crates?
They never had a chance. I was already behind the crates when the attack started.
Wait a minute. You were hiding behind the crates before the attack?
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find me.
You survived because you're lazy?
If you hadn't snuck off for that nap, you'd probably be dead just like all the others.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess. I don't really want to think about it.
You're Cole's contact here on the docks for the smuggling ring.
What? No! I mean, what does it matter now? So I'm a smuggler, who cares? My supervisor's dead, the entire crew's dead. Doesn't matter now, does it?
Anything hidden nearby that we could use against the Geth?
A shipment of grenades came through last week. Nobody notices if a few small pieces go missing from the military orders.
You greedy son of a bitch! We're out here trying to protect your sorry ass, and all you can think about is how you can rip us off?
I never thought you'd actually need those grenades. Who'd want to attack Eden Prime? We're just a bunch of farmers. How was I supposed to know?
Forget about him. He's not worth it.
You're lucky the commander's here, pal. Hand over those grenades.
They're yours. Take them. My smuggling days are over, I swear.
A lot of Marines died here, Powell. Those grenades could have come in handy. If I were you, I'd think of some way to make it up to them.
Yeah, okay. There is something else I was saving. Could be worth a fortune. Experimental technology, top of the line. Take it. I don't need it. I didn't want anyone to get hurt. Really, I'm sorry.
Tell me about the Geth attack.
It was quick. One minute that ship was descending, the next, those Geth were swarming over the platform, thousands of them. They must have been inside that mothership. They shot anything that moved. It was a massacre.
Tell me about this mothership you saw.
I've never seen anything like it before. It was huge. Landed over near that platform. The whole place got dark as it came down. And it was making this noise, this sound that bored right into your brain. That's what woke me up. The attack came a few minutes later.
Is there anything else you can tell me about the beacon?
They brought it here this morning. We loaded it up onto the train and shipped it to the other platform. Hard to believe that was only a few hours ago.
feels like a whole other life.
We need to find that beacon before it's too late.
Take the cargo train. That's where the other Turian went. I can't stay here. I need to get away from all this.
Take out those hostiles!